Hello and welcome to another trip report. This time from railway station in the east of the Netherlands, not far away from the border with Germany. And this trip report will be about a local train that runs between here and Bielefeld in Germany. This is actually the last call for the intercity service in the Netherlands that runs between Amsterdam and Berlin, and the start for these local trains. In this video, I'll first show you this railway station. Won't be a very long review, what's Hengelo railway station, of course. After that, I will show you the train and tiny bit of views from the because Osnabrück is a really important interchange railway station when you're traveling, for example, between the Netherlands and Scandinavia. I will also show you a tiny bit of Osnabrück. Besides that, I did a part of my bachelor over there, so I do have this special bond with the city of Osnabrück. After that, I will show you some more views from the train, and at the end I will show you the railway station of Bielefeld. When you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And well, I want to convince as many people as possible to travel by train, to choose for a sustainable way of transportation. So therefore, please subscribe to my channel, because the bigger this channel is, the more organic traffic will come to my channel. So please subscribe, but also only do this when you like these kinds of videos. For now, let's roll the intro. This is the railway station of Hengelo in the east of Netherlands. It has been opened since 1865 for the line Hengelo-Oldenzaal-Salzbergen, which is also a part of the route that I'll be taking today. In front of the railway station you find a big bus stop, and over here you also find plenty of information screens about departing buses from here. Something else you'll find here is a big parking garage for bikes, a guarded parking garage where you also find the OV fiets. The bike sharing program of the Dutch state-owned railway company can be found under the railway station. In front of the railway station you'll find a tap water point where you can tap, well, water to reduce plastic. Within the main hall at the front of the railway station you'll find a ticket and service desk where you can buy train tickets, but you also find lots of vending machines. I'll explain you more about train tickets for this specific train later on in the video. You'll find lots of other shops, for example a convenience store in the main hall. These screens that you'll find at several spots in this railway station do host information about departing trains from here. Of course, both in the main hall and at the track you will also find these old school timetables. More car related services can be found at the back of the railway station, for example a taxi stand, a drop off and pickup zone, but this is also where you find a parking garage for passengers that will go to the railway station by car. And of course, you also find the car sharing program Green Wheels of the Dutch state-owned railway company. At the back, you also find some space where you can park bikes, although it's not as much as at the front. Time to go to the platform. Actually, you only find one big platform that does host three tracks, because two of these tracks are pretty long. Two of these tracks have been split up in two sections. So when you look at it this way, you will find five tracks over here. From the main hall, you find escalators, elevators and stairs to the platform. An information point can be found near the entrance and the exit of the platform. From here, you will find intercity services that will go to the west of the Netherlands, and most of these trains do terminate at the railway station of Enschede, what is pretty nearby. Like I mentioned, you will also find the intercity service that will go to Berlin, and these trains do run for a big part on the same route as the train that I'll be taking. The local trains that do depart from here are branded with the name Blaunet. This is not the state-owned railway company NS. At the platform you'll find some more facilities, for example a toilet, but this is also where you find a kiosk where you can buy some snacks and drinks. And when it's winter, there's also a warm waiting room inside. By the way, I really like the pictures on the wall over here. The local train that runs between Hengelo, Osnabrück and Bielefeld does depart from track 11. Track 11 is a terminal track, and this track is a little bit hidden from the main tracks. So you have to walk a bit to the east end of this railway station. And this is my train coming in. Before I show you the train, I will give you some small explanation about the ticket for these trains, because this can save you quite a lot of money. This is the route for my train today. As you can see over here, it will cross the border with the Netherlands and Germany and go into the German state Niedersachsen. At this point it will cross the border with another German state, Nordrhein-Westfalen, and over here it will go back again to Niedersachsen to go eventually to Nordrhein-Westfalen again, where it will terminate in Bielefeld. And I probably hear you thinking, well, so what, it's Germany and the Netherlands, right? Well, yes, that's true. But when you're traveling within Germany, you do have these local tickets, and these local tickets are in general only for a specific state and sometimes even for a specific region in a specific state of Germany. This is, for example, the map of where you can use all Niedersachsen tickets. These tickets can also be used from Hengelo on this route to the railway station of Herford, so it's not only for the state of Niedersachsen in Germany. However, my train won't finish at the railway station of Herford, but will continue to Bielefeld in Germany. So you can't use this Niedersachsen ticket for the entire route. From the railway station in Rheine, what is the first stop of North Rhine-Westphalia for these trains, you can also use the NRW, so the North Rhine-Westphalia fare tickets. For example, a Schöner Tag ticket. In general, these local tickets are valid on weekdays from 9 a.m. till the end of the day, and when you buy them on a weekend day, they are valid all day. These tickets are not valid on intercity or intercity express trains, but only on local trains, buses, trams and metros. The rule is, when you use these tickets, the more people will travel on one ticket, the cheaper it is. So the first person pays, well, let's say an amount of 25 euro, and every second person will pay up to 3 or 7 euros more. So what the cheapest option is for you really depends on the group size, where you're going to, if you're going back on the same day or not. But I will explain three constructions over here. For all of these constructions, I assume that you will travel with regular tickets from other points in the Netherlands to the railway station of Hengelo. When you want to continue your way into the North Rhine-Westphalia area, you can best buy a ticket to Rheine, and from Rheine this North Rhine-Westphalia fares are valid. These are called Schöne Tag tickets. The same rule applies at the end of this line as well. You can also use these Niedersachsen fares to Herford, and from Herford you can buy a regular ticket to Bielefeld. Another and maybe the easiest way for these train tickets is to buy a Quer Deutschland ticket. So this is basically a travel ticket for all Germany for one day. You can use all regional trains, and in most cities you're also allowed to use buses, trams and the metro. When you buy paper tickets, you need to write your name on these tickets, but personally I prefer e-tickets and I buy them on my phone in the DB app. Time to check out the trains that are being used for these routes. The trains on this route are the Flirt trains made by Stadler. I guess one of the most common trains you can find in Europe, and especially for local trains. Although I did more trip reports on Flirt trains made by Stadler, the interior is different per edition, because different railway companies have different requirements. At the outside of the train, you can see some information screens that will hold basic route information, and, well, don't work really well with my camera. Of course, you also find information about the different classes and some facilities that are located on that section of the train. Time to enter the train, and I start off by showing you the first class. Well, the first class doesn't give you that much more compared to the second class. You have a little bit more leg space and maybe the seats are a bit more comfortable. I didn't feel the difference. You will find some chairs that will come in airplane or coach composition with a fold-out table in the chair in front, and you'll find some chairs facing each other with a small table in between. A garbage can be found in this table. Near the entrance doors you can find some paper timetables for these trains. Just like first class, second class comes in a 2x2 configuration, so two chairs on both sides of the aisle. About half of the second class chairs do come in a composition like this, so facing each other, and you find a small table at the side near the window. This table does host a garbage can, and this is also where you can find some power plug. The other second class chairs do come in a coach or airplane composition. You do have enough leg space, but I do have to say this might look tighter than it is because I'm a very tall guy. And of course you find a fold out table. Coat hangers can be found just below the luggage rack. Speaking of which, you will find a lot of space for luggage in the overhead luggage racks. For these chairs, you find a power plug right below the chairs. That's one power plug per two chairs. Basic route information will be shown at these screens at the end of the compartments, and screens near the entrance and the exit doors of these trains do host more detailed route information. Within these trains, you will find two vending machines where you can buy train tickets. You can pay in both cash and cards. And you also find two toilets on these trains. This is how the regular toilet looks like, pretty clean, and you also find one toilet for disabled people. Line maps will be visible at several spots in this train, for example over here. Especially near the entrances and the exits of these trains, you do find quite a lot of folding chairs. This is some extra space where you can store luggage, a bicycle, a wheelchair, or when you're traveling with children, a buggy for example. A line map of local transport in the state of North Rhine-Westphalia can be found near the disabled toilet. For the next tiny bit of this video, I'll show you some views between Hengelo and Osnabrück. Right after that, I'll show you the railway station of Osnabrück.
I can sleep the weekend. Holla at a new friend, pour a cup of coffee. Hey, what's your name? Hey, what's your name? Hey, that's right. Hello, hey, goodbye. Hey, that's right. Hello, what's up?
Here at the railway station of Osnabrück, Osnabrück main station. I will show you a very tiny bit of this railway station. Well, to me this is a special city because I did a part of my bachelor study over here. Well, let's show the railway station. In front of the railway station you'll find a bus stop, a taxi stand and some place where you can park bikes. But we're not here to see any of this, because I'm here to talk about this railway station as a railway station where you have to change trains. So, let's enter the railway station. In the main hall near the entrance you will find some vending machines for tickets, but you also find a reisecentrum where you can buy train tickets and go to for information. You find some shops in the main hall, and this is also where you find an information point of DB. A big screen will host information about departing trains from here, and how to go to what platform is indicated really well. The platforms at the lower level do host the east-west connection and the higher level the north-south tracks. As you can see here, you will find stairs that will link the east-west and the north-south tracks with each other. When you prefer to use escalators or elevators, via the main hall you can also go from the east-west to the north-south tracks. Time to continue the journey. From here I'll show you some views between here and Bielefeld, and right after that I'll show you the railway station of Bielefeld. So I'm here in front of the railway station in Bielefeld in Germany. Of course I will also show you this station. And as you can see, well, and the architecture, this really, well, when you saw my video on the Metz to Luxembourg train, this really looks like the railway station in Metz. And well, that station has been built during the first annexation of Metz by Germany. Anyway, I will continue now and show you this railway station. Not far away from the main entrance of the main station, you will find the entrance to the underground. Well, this is only being in the underground in the city center of Bielefeld, but in the outskirts of Bielefeld, this is just a streetcar. You'll find four lines, and all lines will go at the main railway station. And apart from this, you also find a bus stop that's right in front of the railway station. Between the bus stop and the entrance you will find a taxi stand, And something else you find here is this bike sharing program of the German state-owned railway company DB. Of course, I also saw these electric e-steps. I still haven't figured out if I like these e-steps or not. I mean, in a way they're fun, but they can also be quite annoying. Well, the city center ain't far away from here anyway. Well, time to enter the railway station. As you can see, you'll find a big screen that will host information about departing trains. You can't miss it. The main hall of the railway station ain't big. You find the Reisezentrum where you can buy train tickets, an information point, and on the left over here, you will find some shops and places where you can buy food. When you realize that this is a city that does have more than 330,000 inhabitants, this isn't a big station, especially not when you take in consideration that this is the main station. Although this isn't a really important railway junction, at least not for long distance trains, it still feels small for the size of the city. You'll find a tunnel that will connect the tracks to the main hall and the back of the railway station. Within this tunnel, you'll find some toilets and some lockers. And this is also where you'll find some vending machines where you can buy train tickets. I didn't saw them in the main hall. Between the railway station hall, the tracks and the tunnel, you will find escalators, elevators and of course stairs. At the back of the railway station, you will find another small square and some more shops. From the tracks, you can also see the pretty monumental station building. Well, from here, I took a local train to Hamm in North Rhine-Westphalia, from where on I took the train to Venlo in the Netherlands. I also made a video about that route. By the way, the Rhein-Ruhr Express coming in over here, that's a train I took, I also do have a video about these trains. You can find it in the description below the video. So I really hope you liked this video. When you like it, please give me a thumbs up on YouTube. And like I say in all my videos, when you like to see more train related videos, trip reports, subscribe to my channel. And when you subscribe, don't forget to hit the bell button so you get notified when I upload new videos. See you on my next video.